As a musical style, jazz has been called America's classical music and America's only true art form. It was developed around the turn of the century, mostly by black musicians, combining Afro-American and European style. Thus said, one would not immediately think of the Philippines as a haven for jazz, but believe it or not, there is such a thing as a Pinoy jazz tradition. Author and musician Richie Carino continues to chronicle this movement with his latest book, Contemporary Jazz in the Philippines. And he's here to talk about exactly that and all that jazz. Welcome, Richie.
Welcome.
Thanks so much for joining us here on Adulmination. Yeah. So, Richie, Contemporary Jazz in the Philippines is your third book.
That's right.
The very first one, which is right here, Pinoy Jazz Traditions, actually traces the beginnings of jazz in the Philippines. And you said that it actually made it to our shores as early as the 1800s.
Actually, even before that, because we have a Filipino community in New Orleans.
No kidding.
The first TNTs landed in Louisiana and made New Orleans their home because it was very much like the environment in the Philippines.
I absolutely agree. I've just been down there, and it's really like Manila.
Yeah, and they have they set up five villages, one of which was called the Manila Village.
Wow.
Yeah. So you go way back, and so Filipinos were witnessed the beginnings of jazz because when they were there when jazz was born.
Right. Yeah. So, well, and naturally because we love making gaya-gaya, and we're also such a musical culture, we actually embraced it right away.
Exactly.
So what now does Filipino, like what does Pinoy jazz sound like as opposed to American jazz? Is there a difference?
Yes, it's a little different. A merry mix of everything from the traditions from Dixieland to swing, big band, bebop, and eventually we adopted it as our own. And in the last 10 to 12 years, it's been a very creative time for us Filipinos. I think basically because of the U.S. bases pulled out in 1991.
Oh, that was a big factor.
That was a big transition, and it's sort of they pulled the rug from under us, which I think was good for us.
Mm-hmm.
To really look into ourselves and to find our own identity.
But to find something original.
Yes, and so there's been so many artists, musicians that have been coming out with CDs over the last 12 years. And
so right now in the Philippines, who are the big players or who are the names that you follow when you go and listen?
Well, I'm very much involved with the movement. As a musician, I'm a drummer and a percussionist at the same time. And so I felt that I had to chronicle this legacy of great Filipino players because you can find a Filipino musician in every nook and cranny of this world.
That's very true.
That's true.
Right. So who are some names? I mean, just so that Arcanation can go and Google and download and check them out.
Oh, there's quite a few. I think at the forefront of this Pinoy jazz sounding thing is Bob Aves.
Bob Aves.
And his wife, Grace Nono.
Oh, yes.
And then you have Johnny Alegre, and he's come up with some original stuff. But American sounding, which is okay.
Yeah.
And you have the Amp Big Band, which is headed by an old classmate of mine, Mel Villena.
Okay.
And I'm sure you know of him. He was the musical director of Sharon Cuneta.
Wow.
For the longest time.
Okay.
And of course, you have Scarlett, who has her own club called the Scarlett Jazz Kitchen.
So that's kind of where to go when you're in Manila to see some good jazz.
Right. That's near your ABS-CBN studios on Timog Avenue.
Fabulous.
And then you have Merck's Bar and Bistro.
Okay.
Owned by the Prince of Jazz, Richard Merck, the son of Annie Brazil.
Right. Where can we find contemporary jazz in the Philippines?
Oh, this three books were published by Anvil Publishing, which is the sister company of National Bookstore, the largest retailer of books in the Philippines.
So any National Bookstore will have it?
Only selected ones in the Metro Manila area. And then some stores like the CC Cultural Center of the Philippines, a gift shop, the Ayala Museum, the Filipinos Heritage Museum, the Yuchenko Museum.
Dito po sa US, is it available online? Can we like go to Amazon.com and buy it there?
Yes, or you can go to Anvil Publishing.
Or Anvil Publishing.com
and order it directly.
Website.
Yes,
great.
But this documentary is interesting because it's available over filmbaby.com. Which is an American-based website that specializes in independently produced documentaries.
Right. Well, and this is kind of these three books in a nutshell.
Condensed.
Correct. Well, maybe I'm going to buy something from filmbaby.com.
And what's nice about it is it's got 22 soundtracks.
So you actually can listen to the music
exactly,
as well.
Yeah,
that's great.
And see the images and, you know, feel it right there. If you don't, a lot of people don't have time nowadays to sit down and read books.
Yeah, absolutely.
So that's what this is for.
Well, thank you so much for joining us, Richie.
I'm
sorry we don't have more time to chat because this is a really rich topic and I'd love to pick your brain on it.
Oh, sure.
But
anytime,
but thank you anyway for keeping Pinoy music alive and Pinoy jazz in particular.
And thank you for having me here.
You're very welcome.